Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of Blockchain Central. Today we'll look into Zcash. Is it the holy grail of totally anonymous transactions? Before we start, please note that this content does neither represent financial, legal, or tax advice, nor is it supposed to be understood or interpreted as solicitation to buy or sell any securities, coins, or tokens. In today's video, we'll take a closer look at Zcash. Zcash operates similarly to Bitcoin with one major difference. Zcash, unlike Bitcoin, which emphasizes pseudonymity, allows for completely anonymous transactions within the network. Anonymity and privacy are, of course, important topics among blockchain enthusiasts, but they can also bring skepticism from experts and regulators. Over the course of this video, we'll take a closer look at the functionalities of Zcash. We will also talk about the zero knowledge proof of Zcash, explain the founder's reward, and discuss the anonymity of its technology. So, let's get started. Zcash was brought to life at the end of 2016 by Zuko Wilcox. The currency can be used for both payments and storage of value and is primarily characterized by high anonymity. Zcash is a decentralized open source software based on the Zero Coin protocol, which is basically a privacy-oriented extension of the Bitcoin protocol. That is why Zcash and Bitcoin share many similarities. For all of you who are not familiar with the concept behind Bitcoin, please check out our analysis. For all of you who already know Bitcoin, the following features may sound very familiar. Zcash rewards miners for verification of transaction with coins, and the total supply of coins is limited to 21 million. Roughly every 2.5 minutes, a new block on the Zcash blockchain is created, and the 12.5 Zcash are released as a reward for mining the block. For every 4 years, the block reward will be cut in half, which is also the same as it is for Bitcoin. Unlike Bitcoin, however, 10% of all coins mined are added to the founder's reward. We will explain this concept and the controversy it brings later in the video. But for now, let's talk about the Zcash network and transactions. Users of Zcash can choose between two types of transactions, unshielded and shielded payments. Unshielded payments are similar to the transactions of the Bitcoin network. The transactions are stored on the public blockchain, and the information on the sender's address, recipient address, and account transferred is transparent to every user in the network. In order to make truly anonymous transactions, users have to activate the optional shielded payment feature. In this case, Zcash makes use of the so-called zk-SNARK, zero knowledge proof. This concept allows transactions between two participants without publicly releasing the sender's address, recipient's address, or amount transferred, by mathematically validating the transaction and preventing double spending. As a result of the separation between unshielded and shielded payments, two pools of Zcash coins exist, and the question is what happens when those two pools are mixed up. Two studies, one from University College London and one from University Michigan Dearborn, have analyzed the privacy of Zcash and concluded, quite alarmingly, that when coins move from unshielded to shielded and then back to the unshielded pool, anonymity is largely compromised. The researchers were able to trace back between 30% and 70% of all coins, which were sent to the shielded addresses, and could find trading patterns and identify the movement of coins within the network. Another issue contributing to the anonymity of the shielded coins is the relatively small size. In December 2017, less than 4% of all Zcash coins were located in the shielded pool, and most wallet providers did not support transactions with shielded Zcash addresses. In addition, complete anonymity has again been criticized by experts and regulators, as it means that the cryptocurrencies can be used for illegal transactions on the dark web or for money laundering. Regulators are aware of this danger and are therefore skeptical towards fully anonymous cryptocurrencies. In Japan, the FSA asked exchanges to delist three cryptocurrencies known for their high privacy, including Zcash. Even though the advocates of Zcash claim many legal use cases for anonymous payments, there is still much skepticism about the anonymous use of Zcash. Outside of the privacy discussion, the founder's reward issue we mentioned before is also causing significant controversy. In the first 4 years of Zcash, miners receive only 80% of the reward, and the remaining 20% goes to the founder's reward, which is later transferred to Zcash Electric Coin Company. It distributes the coins to founders, investors, employees, and advisors to incentivize them to improve the value of the coin. Afterwards, about one quarter of the founder's reward is forwarded to the Zcash Company Strategic Reserve and the nonprofit Zcash Foundation for maintenance and further development of the Zcash protocol. Whereas some people criticize the fact that the developers are so openly being rewarded by their own network, others praise the system transparency and clean funding guidelines. So what can we take away from this video? First of all, we now know that Zcash is very similar to Bitcoin, can conduct transactions faster than Bitcoin, and allows for complete anonymity. However, the privacy feature has some shortcomings, and the users can inadvertently cause transactions which were initially intended to stay anonymous to be traced back to the public wallet address in the Zcash network. Also, both the anonymity itself and the mechanics of the founder's reward is added to the controversy surrounding Zcash. That's it for this episode of Blockchain Central. Let me know in the comments what you think about the founder's reward mechanics, and also, make sure to hit the like button if you like this video. And don't forget to subscribe to Blockchain Central to never miss a beat. Happy investing.